वेलकम डियर लिसनर्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस बायो इक्विवेलेंस स्टडीज। लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, स्टूडेंट शुड एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड बायो इक्विवेलेंस स्टडीज, देन रिक्वायरमेंट एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस बायो इक्विवेलेंस, टाइप ऑफ बायो इक्विवेलेंस that is in vivo bioequivalence and in vitro bioequivalence. Definition: it refers to a drug substance in two or more identical dosage form reaches systemic circulation at the same rate to same relative extent. It's nothing but bioequivalence. If you have a two or more dosage form with you, then we can say that it is these are bioequivalent when their rate of reaching of this dosage form into the systemic circulation is same and to same relative extent. Then we can say that both of these or all of these formulations are bioequivalent. That is, their plasma concentration and time profile will be identical without significant statistical differences. Means rate of entering of your drug into the systemic circulation into plasma, it should be same. And it should shows same plasma concentration time profile. Means suppose one dosage form is having a half life 3 hours, then second should also have a same half life. Or both of these drugs should remain into fixed period of time into the therapeutic level. Means all these things should be followed by your both of this dosage form, then you can say that both of these are bioequivalent. Advantages of this bioequivalent studies: it helpful to minimize effect of inter subject variability, and then help to minimize the carry over effects. It requires less number of subjects to get meaningful results as compared to the other methods. Then disadvantages with bioequivalence: it requires longer time to complete study. Then completion of studies totally depend on number of formulations evaluated in this study. Means for how much formulation you want to show that these formulations are bioequivalent. Means time period is totally depend upon how much dosage form you want to show bioequivalence. Then increase in study period leads to high subject dropouts. There might be subject dropout because of the longer period of time. Then medical ethics does not allow too many trials on subject continuously for longer time. These are disadvantages with this bioequivalence study. Now we'll see what are the objectives behind this study. Development of suitable dosage form for new drug entity. Then determination of influence of excipients and patient related factors and possible interaction with other drugs. That will be determined by using this bioequivalence studies. Then we can develop new dosage form for new drug entity by performing these bioequivalent studies. Development of new drug formulation of existing drug means drugs are there in a market and you want to develop new formulation for that drug. In such a type of cases, you can just perform bioequivalence study. No need to go for these preclinical and clinical studies. control of quantity of drug products, then its influence on a processing factor, storage and stability, then comparison of availability of drug substances from different forms. Ultimately, this study will give us comparative results of all formulations of that particular drug or same dosage form produced by different manufacturer. Then reference product. Now, which product should be considered as reference during this bioequivalence study? Identified by the regulatory authorities as designated reference product, usually global innovator products, then protected by a patent. This type of product we can take as a reference. Then marketed under manufacturer's brand name. Clinical efficacy and safety profile is well documented in extensive trial. All generics must be bioequivalent to it. And in India, CDSCO may approve another product as a reference product. With these type of product we can take as a reference product, and we can conduct this bioequivalence study for such a type of formulation or such type of products. Now, what exactly difference between NDA and ANDA review process? NDA is your common method for approval of drug, that is new drug application for marketing purpose, and ANDA is abbreviated method of drug to enter into the market. Now, what exactly difference between these two methods, NDA and ANDA? In case of this NDA and ANDA, chemistry manufacturing data is required, then control, labeling, testing, everything is required. But in case of NDA application, this animal study and clinical study has to be performed by this innovator. Then bioavailability of your drug is determined. But in case of this ANDA application, instead of this three studies, preclinical, clinical and bioavailability study, only bioequivalence study has to be conducted by this ANDA sponsor. Indian legislation. In India, CDSCO provide guideline for this bioavailability and bioequivalence study mentioned into the Schedule Y. And as per BNC and their amendments 2005, all bioavailability and bioequivalence study should be conducted in accordance with this guideline. Now, what exactly Orange Book? All FDA approved drug listed into this Orange Book. Cover of this book is of orange color, so it is called as Orange Book, and it consists of list all FDA approved drug. NDAs, ANDAs and OTCs are there in this book. Then expiration dates of patents are there. Drug Price and Competition Act 1984. FDA required to publish approved drug product with their therapeutic equivalence and evaluation. Then concept of this equivalency. Equivalency is a relative term that compare drug products with respect to specific characteristic or function or to as defined set of standards. means you have to consider a specific characteristic or function, and that you have to prove equivalent in both of these dosage form. Now here plasma time profile is our function or characteristic that has to be equivalent into different dosage form, then we can say that these dosage forms are bioequivalent. Then there are several type of equivalencies. First one is chemical equivalence, pharmaceutical equivalence, then bioequivalence and therapeutic equivalence. Now we'll see one by one. First, that is chemical equivalence. This chemical equivalence indicates two or more drug products contain same labeled chemical substances as an active ingredient in a same amount. Means suppose I have a two analgesic formulation with me of say for example paracetamol. Okay, companies are different, but strength of this paracetamol is same in both of these formulation, then we can say that it is chemically equivalent. Okay, means if I have a paracetamol with me and prozin with me, and both of this formulation is having 650 milligram of paracetamol, that is API, means I can say that both of this paracet as well as prozin is chemically equivalent, because both of this formulation is consist of or contains 650, that is equivalent amount of your drug. So we can say that these formulations are chemically equivalent. Then second type of equivalence, that is pharmaceutical equivalence. Now this term implies that two or more drug products are identical in strength, quality, then purity, content uniformity, and they may however differ in containing different excipients. Strength, quality, purity, content uniformity is same, disintegration profile, dissolution profile is same, but different excipients are there into two different dosage form, so we can say that it is pharmaceutically equivalent. Then third type of equivalency, that is bioequivalence. Now this bioequivalence means drug substance in two or more identical dosage form reaches into the systemic circulation at same relative rate and to the same relative extent. Their plasma concentration time profile will be identical without significant statistical differences. When statistically significant differences are observed in bioavailability of two or more drug products, then bioequivalence inequivalence is indicated. Plasma concentration time profile means after administration of your drug, in how much period of time it is entering into the therapeutic level, how much time period it remains into therapeutic level, then what is elimination rate of this drug, everything or this information will come to know from this plasma concentration time profile. So if plasma concentration time profile matches for both drug or more drugs, then we can say that these dosage forms are bioequivalent. Then fourth type of equivalence, that is therapeutic equivalence. Now this therapeutic equivalence indicates that two or more drug products that contain the same therapeutically active ingredient and elicits identical pharmacological effect and can control disease in a same extent, means both of your drug product is giving you same therapeutic effect or pharmacological effect, which is helpful to control particular disease condition. Then bioequivalence can be demonstrated either in vivo or in vitro. Now we'll discuss one by one. That is, first is in vivo bioprevalence study. Following sequence of criteria is useful for conducting these in vivo bioprevalence studies. First, oral immediate release products with systemic action indicated for serious conditions requiring assured response. Then narrow therapeutic margin, pharmacokinetics complicated by absorption, then is less than 70% or absorption window, non-linear kinetics or pre-systematic elimination should be greater than 70%, unfavorable physiochemical properties like low solubility, then metastable modification, instability. These are some unfavorable physiochemical properties. Then documented evidence for this bioavailability problem. No relevant data available unless justification by applicant that in vivo study is not necessary. Then non-oral immediate release product, modified release product with systemic action. In vivo bioprevalence study are conducted in a usual manner as discussed for bioavailability study, that is a pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic methods. Now here you have to determine that your pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic parameter of both of this drug, that drug you have selected for showing both of these drugs are bioequivalent. Then pharmacokinetic methods are used to provide bioequivalence. First, plasma level time profile studies are there. Then urinary excretion studies also conducted. Means a rate of elimination of your drug you have to determine into the in vivo models. Then you have to determine plasma level time studies. Then pharmacodynamic methods for determination of in vivo bioequivalence, that is acute pharmacological response, therapeutic response. Then in vitro bioequivalence studies. Now in vitro studies means outside these animal or other than animal studies, these studies are conducted for in vitro bioequivalence. That in vivo bioequivalence studies are conducted into the different animal species, and that data you have to show to the regulatory agency. And second type of this bioequivalence study, that is in vitro bioequivalence study. Here you have to simulate in vivo condition into the in vitro, and you have to show that your drug is bioequivalence. If none of above criteria is applicable, comparative in vitro dissolution studies will suffice. In vitro studies, that is dissolution study, can be used in lieu of in vivo bioequivalence under certain circumstances called bioweavers. The drug product differs only in a strength of active substance it contains provided all following conditions that has to be hold, that is pharmacokinetic parameters are linear, then qualitative composition should be same, ratio between active ingredient and excipient should be same, then ratio between excipient is also same, both products are produced by same manufacturer at the same production site. Bioavailability or bioequivalent study has been performed with original product under the same test condition, and in vitro dissolution rate should be same. Then drug product has been slightly reformulated or manufacturing method has been slightly modified by this original manufacturer in ways that can convincingly be argued to irrelevant for the bioavailability. Means slight modification is there than the reference compound. The drug product meets all following requirements. The drug product is in a form of solution or solubilized form like elixir, syrup and tinctures. Then drug product contains active ingredients in the same concentration as the approved drug product or reference product. The product contain no excipient known to significantly affect absorption of API. An acceptable in vivo in vitro correlation and in vitro dissolution rate of new drug product is equivalent with that already approved medicinal product. Since you have to perform dissolution study and you have to show that your reference product and your test product both are having same dissolution profile, and you have to correlate this in vitro condition with in vivo. That is nothing but in vivo in vitro correlation. Then product is intended for topical administration for local effect. The product is for oral administration. Product is administered inhalation as a gas or vapors. Then criteria for drug product listed into these above three class, that bioavailability and bioequivalence are self-evident but not intended to be absorbed. Okay, this is all about bioequivalence study. Thank you.